हाई एवरी वन, माई सेल्फ कनकराजु वेल्ली, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन मेकानिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, वरंगल इंस्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड साइंस. वेलकम टू विट्स कनेक्ट. टुडे अवर लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस परमिजबल वर्किंग स्ट्रेस ऑफ गे टीथ इन द लुईस इक्वेशन. परमिजबल वर्किंग स्ट्रेस फॉर गे टीथ इन द लुईस इक्वेशन. In this one, we are using Lewis equation. Find out the working stress. Working stress is denoted by working stress. In the, using this one, we want to find out the working stress is denoted by sigma w. In the Lewis equation, depends upon materials. In the Lewis equation, depend upon type of material for which allowable shear stress. That allowable stress is denoted by sigma naught. The allowable static stress at the elastic limit of the material. Elastic limit of the material. We are using Lewis equation. In this one, we find out the working stress sigma w, allowable stress sigma naught. In this one, the allowable static stress in the stress at elastic limit at the material, elastic limit material. The permissible working stress, the permissible working stress is denoted by sigma w. Already we know that sigma w is equal to allowable stress into Cv. Using this one, we find out the working stress. Okay, in this one, sigma naught, already we know that allowable stress. What is Cv? Cv is equal to velocity factor. Velocity first. After that, we find out the this working stress. In this one, actually, Cv is equal to what? There are some conditions are there. Like Cv is equal to 3/3 + V. That is for ordinary cut gears. Okay, let's see. Okay students, permissible working stress for gear teeth in the Lewis equation, already we know that sigma w is equal to sigma naught into Cv. Sigma w is equal to what? Working stress, and sigma naught allowable stress. Cv is equal to velocity factor. Okay, how to find out to Cv velocity factors? There are some conditions are there. Like Cv is equal to 3/3 + V. CV is equal to 3P, 3 by 3 plus V. This is for ordinary cut. Ordinary cut gears velocity up to 12.5 meter per second. Next term, CV is equal to 4.5 by 4.5 plus V. This is for carefully cut gears. Velocity is also same, 12.5 meter per second. Next term, CV is equal to 6 by 6 plus V. Okay, this is for accuracy cut. Accuracy cut, velocity up to 20 meter per second. Next, CV is equal to 0.75 by 0.75 plus V. This is for precision gear cut with high accuracy. With high accuracy, as is same velocity up to 20 meter per second. If any problem, there is a ordinary cut gears velocity up to 12.5 meter per second, then we taking CV is equal to 3 by 3 plus V. Next, anyone for carefully gear cut gear velocity up to 12.5 meter per second. Then we take CV is equal to 4.5 by 4.5 plus V. Next, for accurately cut velocity up to 12 meter per second, we take CV is equal to 6 by 6 plus V. Next, precision car gear velocity gear cut with high accuracy velocity up to 20 meter per second, we take CV is equal to 0.75 by 0.75 plus V. These all are some conditions, okay, important conditions how to find out the velocity factor. Okay, students, now another topic is dynamic tooth load. How to find out dynamic tooth load? In this dynamic tooth load is denoted by WD. Okay, WD is equal to WT plus WI. What is a WT? Dynamic tooth load. What is the WD first? DWD is equal to total dynamic load. Total dynamic load. Okay, if you want to find out the total dynamic load, we want WT plus WI. Okay, what is WT is equal to? WT is equal to study load due to transmitting torque. This is a study load due to transmitting torque is denoted by WT. Next, WI or omega I. WI increment load. Increment load due to dynamic action. In this one, WD is equal to WT plus WI. Then dynamic load, total dynamic load is equal to WT plus WI. Okay, using this one, WI formula is like 21 V into 21 V is into BC plus WT. This is standard formula by 21 V plus under root BC plus WT. This is the standard formula. Okay, using this formula we find out the total dynamic load. total dynamic load. In this one, in this formula, what is V? V is equal to small v. V is equal to pitch line velocity. Pitch line velocity. Pitch line velocity is the units in mm, meter per second. Units meter per second. What is B? B is a face width. Face width. Face width. Next, what is C? C is equal to deformation. C is equal to deformation. If you want to find out the total dynamic load, then we want V pitch line velocity, B face width, and C deformation. Okay, this is a dynamic load, dynamic tooth load equation. Dynamic tooth load equation, WD is equal to WT plus WI. In this one, WD is equal to total dynamic load, WT is steady load due to transmitting torque, WI is equal to increment load due to dynamic action. Substitute WI is equal to 21V into B into C plus WT by 21V plus under root B small b into small c plus WT. This equation, in this one, substitute equation, dynamic load equation. Let's WD is equal to WT plus 21V BC into plus WT by 21V plus under root B into C plus WT. Okay, this is a dynamic load, dynamic tooth load equation, final equation. To the dynamic tooth load, in the dynamic tooth already we know that this equation. Okay, in this equation, C, how to find out C? C is equal to formula, another formula is there. K into E by 1 by EP plus 1 by EG. Okay, what is K, what is E, what is EP, what is EG? Let's see. K is equal to, K means a factor depending upon the form of the teeth. A factor depending upon the form of the teeth. In this one, there are some conditions are there. Different conditions, we are using different values. That is 0.107. This is for 14 and a half degrees full depth in involute system. Next, 0.111. For 20 degrees full depth involute system. This is also involute system, but 20 degrees full depth. Next, K is equal to 0.115 for 20 degrees stub system. These three are the values, K values. Next, E is equal to total error action. If in our problem, error action is like total error action is 6 or 10, then substitute 6, 10. Next, EP, what is EP? EP is equal to Young's modulus for the material of the pinion. Pinion material, Young's modulus of the pinion material. EG is equal to Young's modulus for the material of the gear. Gear material, Young's modulus value. Okay, what is the Young's modulus value, gear and pinion. Let's after that substitute all those values, then find out the dynamic total dynamic load, tooth load. Okay, using this equation, total dynamic load equation. Okay, this is the main equation. Okay, thank you.